Hello everyone, this video is about inbound solution with DTMF or menu input. Inbound solution is very helpful for various businesses to track and manage their leads and connect with them. Here, I have put an example of a two-level inbound solution where when a customer calls on the Super Receptionist number or virtual number, they will hear a welcome message followed by main menu options. And after selecting the main menu options, they will further hear submenu options. For example, welcome to Knowlarity as their welcome message, followed by please press 1 if you are a new customer, please press 2 if you are an existing customer as their main menu options. After selecting the main desired main menu options, they will further hear submenu options like 3, press 1 if for sales, please press 2 for support, and similarly for the other option also, please press 1 for sales and please press 2 for support. After selecting the desired submenu options, the call will be routed to agents or representatives mapped to these submenu extensions. When delivering this type of solution, Knowlarity provides two panels to the user. One is the Super Receptionist panel and second is the backend panel or MySQL panel. This is your Super Receptionist panel. To access this panel, type sr.knowlarity.com in your search bar and this page will open. You will be provided with a username and a password. Enter those credentials and click on login button here and you will have access to this panel. The second panel is your backend panel. This is your backend panel or MySQL panel. Type sr.knowlarity.com in the search bar and this page will open. A separate username and password will be provided to you. Enter those credentials and you will have access to this panel. I'll be first explaining the backend panel. Once you log in, this is how your backend panel will look and you will have access to all these tables. I'll quickly go through all the tables and explain what are these tables for. The first table is the blacklist table. When you want to block a caller and do not want this caller to connect with your IVR, then you can blacklist them through this blacklist table. Click on this table and this is how your table will look. The Knowlarity number is your virtual number and the blacklist number is the caller number which you want to block. To add the record in this table, there is an add record button here in the right corner. Click on the record button. Double click here and you can edit and enter your virtual number or your SR number like this. Double click here and now you can add your caller number which you want to blacklist. I'm adding a dummy number. Click anywhere outside the screen so that this update record tab is available for updating your records. Click on this update tab. Now your logs are inserted in this table. Click back on this table and now you can see the records is updated here. Now what happens is whoever the blacklist number added here, when these number calls on your virtual number, they will just hear two rings and the call will disconnect. They will not be able to connect with your IVR. This is how you can blacklist your caller. Now next table is your holiday table. If you want to inform your customers or your clients or leads that you are on a holiday due to festivals or any other reason, then you can enter a record in this table. You can enter the record the same way we entered in the blacklist table. Just click on the add record. Double click here, enter your virtual number. Enter the holiday in this format, year, month, and date. You can also add a description to your holiday. Click outside, click on the update record, and your record is inserted. Click back on this table and you can see this record. What happens now is whoever calls on this day, they will hear a holiday message and after the message is played, the call will disconnect. Like, for example, the default message played is, "We apologize that we cannot take your call as we are on holiday. Please call us back." And you can also customize this holiday message as per your requirement. Next table is agent mapping table. This is where you will map all your representatives who will answer the calls landing on your virtual number. For example, if the customer or client selects one in the main menu and wants to connect to a sales representative, then he or she will press one in the submenu. And the configuration of that representative is 1-1 in the mapping table. Similarly, if the customer selects two in the main menu and want to connect to a support representative in the submenu of this main menu, then the configuration of that representative is 2-2 in the mapping table. So whatever the input is given by the customer, their call will be routed to these representatives or agents mapped against the desired extension pressed by the caller. You can also edit or update your agents. Just double click here and you can update it. All the agents should be mapped, comma separated. Click outside anywhere on the screen so that update record tab is visible. Click on the update records. Click back on the table and you can see that the record is updated. So if the caller selects one in the main menu and one in the submenu, then the call will first land on the first representative. If this representative is not able to answer the call, then it will land on the second representative. And if this representative is also not able to answer the call, then it will try the third representative, and so on. Suppose in an ongoing call with the customer, the agent or representative wants to make a conference call and connect to any other representative or manager or supervisor, then there is another table provided called the bridge mapping table. Here you can map your supervisor or manager or any other representative. They will be mapped against a bridge extension number. So to make a conference call, the representative or agent will press star or hash followed by the bridge extension number in their dial pad in an ongoing call with the customer. For example, if the representative wants to connect with this bridge number, then he or she will press *100 or #100 on their dial pad in an ongoing call with the customer or client. Then what happens is, as soon as the representative dials this extension, a call will land on this bridge number. And when this bridge number answers the call, then the caller, the representative which has answered the call here, will and the bridge number will be patched in a conference call. So this is how the conference calling will work. You can add your bridge numbers in the same way we did in the previous table. Just click on the add records. Enter your virtual number. Double click, enter your desired bridge extension and enter the bridge number. This number will be your representative, manager or supervisor's number. Click on update records. When you click back, you can see the record is updated. You can also delete your records here. There's a checkbox here. Click on this checkbox and a delete records tab will be visible. Click on the delete records and when you click back, that record is removed. You can do this also in other tables like your mapping table, holiday table. Just checkbox, click on the checkbox and click on the delete records. And here you can see the record is deleted. This is where you can set your working hours. The IVR will work only between the start time and the end time, as shown here. If your working hour is from 9 a.m. to 9 p.m., then only between 9 a.m. to 9 p.m. the IVR will work as per your business requirement. Else, if the call lands before the start time or after the end time, then a default off hour message will play. This default off hour message is like, we apologize that we cannot take your call at the moment as you have called us beyond our working hours. Please call us back during our working hours and the call will disconnect. This off hour message can also be customized as per your requirements. The working hour table can also be edited as we did in the previous table. So this is the overview of your backend panel. Now moving to your Super Receptionist panel. This is your Super Receptionist login page. Once you log in, this is how your dashboard will look. This is your dashboard. To view the call details, click on this Calls and SMS tab. And a page will open. This will contain all your call records. This is the player where you can hear the recordings between the representative and the customer. Just click on this button and a player will open. When you press this play button, you can hear the recording. You can also download this recording by clicking on this download link here, and the recording will be downloaded in your laptop or computer. You can also filter your call logs between any two dates or filter the calls for a single day. When you scroll above, there is a calendar button here. When you click on this button, a calendar will open. You select a from date and select a to date. Click on the submit button and your calls will be sorted between these two dates. If you want to see the logs for a single day, then click back again on this calendar. Select a from date and select the same to date. And click on this submit button and your call will be filtered for that single day, that is 1st of April here. You can also download these calls in a CSV format report. There is a download button here. When you click on this button, a pop-up will come. It will contain a download link. Just click on this link and a file will be downloaded in your laptop or computer containing all your call record details in a CSV file. There is another feature provided, which is click-to-call feature. It helps the representative to connect with their clients or customers without revealing the contact number of the representatives. So it helps in masking the agent contact number. A separate video is provided on how to initiate a click-to-call from SR. You can watch that video. Next is your Insights tab. Let's just click on this Insights tab. When you click on this Custom Analytics sub-tab, a new window will open. This window will have different reports related to your IVR. It will have different charts, and these charts and reports can be customized as per your requirement. You can see all this report here. So this is the overview of your inbound solution with TTMF input. Goodbye.